We're going to start now. Here we go.
This is one of the most anxiety-provoking exercises a person can do. This machine, it's called a Humphrey, randomly blinks tiny lights, and I'm to click when I see one. The ones I miss measure my vision loss.
All those numbers there that you see that are zeros are blind spots. He doesn't see those areas.
You see, I have glaucoma, and I've been clicking for almost 20 years. You can see how the disease is robbing me of my sight. That was my vision a few years ago, when I first started making the film Going Blind. Since then, it has gotten worse. My vision often looks like it's seen through dirty glasses. Oncoming traffic at night gives me a blinding glare. My ability to read with my left eye is especially impaired.
Not as sharp, right?
This is the old one, not as sharp, but it's not sharp.
I mean, it's not crisp with this.
Yeah, maybe it's just not
just,
there.
That's just the way it's probably going to be.
In the United States, some treatments can slow or stop vision loss from optic nerve damage, but none can reverse it. However, I heard of a study in Magdeburg, a medieval German town about 2 hours from Berlin, where researchers are making strides in actually reversing vision loss. I decided to give it a try.
We have about 15 people here in the research group of different disciplines, and all of them focus more or less on the issue of restoring vision. We have most recently started work on non-invasive brain stimulation.
The work is based on 20 years of research done on thousands of patients at the Human Brain Institute in St. Petersburg, Russia. This is the concept. The optic nerve brings the data the eye senses to the brain, and the brain interprets that data as sight. But an optic nerve damaged by glaucoma brings less data back to the brain. With electric brain stimulation, the hope is to improve the brain's ability to interpret the data coming in through the damaged optic nerve. When I first arrived, we spent 2 days evaluating my vision, so we could compare results before and after. This included visual fields, as well as EEGs, to measure brain waves. My visual fields show what vision I have left. The white is good, the black is gone, and the various shades of gray indicate what is called residual vision.
It's these areas of partial function, where vision is neither absent nor normal, that give us an opportunity for restoration and repair.
We got your data, and now we have some conclusion about it. Left eye still central area seems to be clear, but surroundings much worse. But still, we have some kind of gray dots. It means probably it's the islands will respond to the treatment first.
The treatment is the administration of alternating current. First, 4 electrodes are attached around my eyes. To decide how much electricity I'll get, Dr. Fedoroff introduces the alternating current slowly into each electrode. The current goes through my eye and optic nerve and into my brain. I detect a sense of movement. Then I see what appears. Current increases, so does the clarity of the light. Once it is clear that I really am seeing light, I signal Dr. Fedoroff.
Okay.
Yeah, good.
Then he adjusts the frequency. The light starts to flicker, and he increases the frequency until the flickering stops. And then we're ready to go. For 20 to 40 minutes each day, the current is introduced to each electrode in a figure-eight pattern. And that's it.
it's about half of the patients who benefit from the therapy, and some that profit have marginal or less pronounced improvements, but there are others who have massive improvements.
Two weeks later, more evaluations, visual fields and EEGs. And then I find out which sort I'll be.
Die Mutter der Marmelade ist die Quitte. Sie gab dem Protostrich ihren Namen Portugiesisch Marmelo Quitte. What does that mean?
It means you can read.
That's pretty good. Even though I don't know what I'm saying, I can read it.
Yeah, exactly. And I would like to conclude that we got from your side, during your examination, good results. Because not only you could read better and mm-hmm. see better, but also your visual field now looks better and it's significant. And here is your visual field charts, especially for your left eye. Mm-hmm. And before the therapy, you see mostly we have this central, this scotoma near your center, which affect to your central vision also. And after 10 sessions, brain mm-hmm. stimulation, mm. If you're looking for the central area, we see that centrally your visual field starts more clear. Exactly this defect area plus this area also can be explained in terms of improvement, mm-hmm. because it practically seems to be like intact area. These changes help you to start to read again.
I'm happy to look at small changes. These are more than small. Wow. And there are other improvements. The smudginess of my vision has been corrected. When I check my glasses to see if they are dirty, they really are. Glare has been greatly diminished, especially from oncoming traffic and in airports. And my acuity has improved in both eyes.
I still don't like my deficit. But I think exploring a new avenue has energized me and made me feel more optimistic about the different directions that people could go in research and the different ways that could be looked at in terms of attacking some of these issues of blindness. I think there's a lot of resignation in ophthalmology, mm-hmm. and that's not a good thing.
Now it's time to change our thinking about how to treat brain functions. We should take advantage of the tremendous plasticity that the brain has. That's why it's great to get together with other collaborating research institutions to work together to shape the future of neurological treatment and therapy. And by doing so, we'll have new options available that never was thought of before and that will give us an advantage of helping many, many patients in the years to come.